Alright guys, today we're out here on Hirschfelden once again to try our luck and see if we can finally find one of the 3 rares we need of this reserve. And as you can see, I just stumbled on the track of a potential level 3 roe deer. Maybe our first diamond roe deer on Hirschfelden after more than a year, so let's go try to find it. You know, whenever you're tracking a deer species that already heard you and already spooked, you gotta be really careful to not spook them again, because each time they run quite far, and if you just keep running behind them, you can easily end up in a 3-4 kilometer chase before you can even get a chance to take a shot. So the best approach to track these fast species on this dense reserve is to just walk. Just be patient, and eventually, it's very likely the animal will do a warning call whenever you are getting close. Warning call. I'ma go prone. And let's try to spot him from here. We may be about to see a level 3 roe deer. And there he is. Level 2, he doesn't seem to be huge, he has an estimate of 68 to 80, so he doesn't have any chance to make it, but we're still gonna drop him using the 243 Cuomo. Should be a single long at least. He won't be a massive buck by any means, but it ain't too bad to start the hunt. 70.58, just a medium sized colt. We hit a single long at 96 meters and we tracked it for 1.13 kilometers. Not too bad. Okay, same session, and now we have the track of a potential max level European bison. He may be a big level 4 or a diamond potential level 5, so we must find it. Right there. That's a female. She will go down. The second shot was probably bad, but the first one was definitely viral. Gonna do the same with this other cow, which also won't go too far. And I imagine the big male was also here a few seconds ago. There's a bull over there. And it's the big one, max estimate. He's a level 4, so he doesn't have any chance to make it, but it still could be a massive colt. Gonna harvest these 2 cows and then we'll see how big is that massive level 4. We almost hit hard on the first shot on this one, we were really close. And as for the second female, a terrible shot the first time, and a decent liver stomach long on the second. Now let's see the size of this level 4. 230.77, we actually hit hard on the first shot, and the second shot was as unnecessary as it was off. So let's continue and let's see if we can find a bigger bison. Alright guys, we're still on the exact same session, and this time I came across the track of a potential level 3 pheasant. The tracks are very old, so this guy may be more than 100 meters away from this position, maybe even more than 1 kilometer, and the only thing we know is that he's feeding right now because at the moment we're at their feed time. So we're gonna begin the chase slowly, and hopefully we'll provoke a warning call or something that gives us a hint about his position. Okay, warning call. He may be feeding around there with the whole flock and they are probably about to take off. So let's go for it. They always take a few seconds to flush, so they should be here. Oh! Level 3! And the other one is a max estimate as well. We hit the level 3 and I try to hit the other one, but we missed both shots. Well, we just dropped a level 3 rooster. I didn't pay attention to the trophy estimate of the other max estimate, so it could be massive. And in fact, he may be about to fly this way just as all these females. I actually just heard another pheasant flying, but I don't see him. So if he was here, he's already gone. But anyway, let's harvest this potential diamond. Hopefully my 3rd diamond pheasant on Hirschfelden. And it is a diamond, 20.61. He has the molting plumage, which ain't rare but makes it a bit more special. And I gotta say that recently my luck with the pheasants has been quite impressive. I mean, we've gotten 3 diamonds in the last month or so. And this ain't the easiest diamond to find, actually they are one of the rarest, so not too bad. Now we gotta find the other max estimate, which I imagine could also be a diamond. Would be absolutely insane to get two diamonds of the same flock, so we definitely gotta try to find it. The max estimate. 15 to 18 estimate. No chance to make it, he's actually quite small. And there are a lot more hens coming in, these are a blast to hunt. I will never get tired of saying that there are some maps that could really benefit from the addition of some extra upland bird species. There are so many species that I would love to see added. And while this rooster ain't too big, 17.96 core, so not a giant, but we already got 8 diamonds, so let's continue and let's try to find a melanistic now. Another big track. This time it is from a potential level 5 European bison, and they are very recent, so they should be around the corner. The European bison, in contrast with the deer species and the pheasant, is really easy to track. They are super slow, so in order to chase them effectively, running behind them is actually a good strategy. You can easily reach them and get within the range of whatever rifle you are using by just running towards them. It's super easy and they are amazing to make money. You know, using something like the 470, you can perfectly wipe out an entire herd and make like $10,000 in just a matter of minutes. There goes the rest of the herd. Those are all cows. And I assume that's the big male. Is he a level 5? No, level 4. Top estimate of 294, so he may be giant. But as far as I'm concerned, the level 4 European bisons cannot make it, I've never seen one posted. So I don't expect him to be a giant, but just gonna shoot a few of these cows before we go harvesting. Not too bad. As for this guy, a 246.19 score, decent size gold, we hit a double long 2 times, both shots were pretty much identical, so not bad at all, that is a decent trophy. Okay, same session, and on this occasion we have the track of what I hope will finally be a level 9 red fox. We've had easily more than 10 of these max estimates in the last couple weeks, and none of them has been a diamond, so who knows, maybe this one. Alright. He knows we're here. And considering that right now is the red fox rest time, I think it's likely he's spared down there. Honestly, I doubt the max estimate hasn't spooked yet, he doesn't seem to be near this position anymore. So let's go try to find it for a second time. Let's see if it is a legendary. I hear him. Right there. Level 8. 11 to 13 estimate, no potential to be huge. We are gonna drop him on the throat using the 243 Cuomo. Let's see. He is down. A 13.07 mythical red fox. We tracked it for 3.39 kilometers, quite a long chase, and we hit a double long at 79 meters. I honestly love to chase and hunt this guy, so even though he wasn't massive, I'm happy with it. Alright guys, different session, and I just spotted a monster roe deer. An absolute giant. He is walking behind that bush, probably heading towards a feed zone because right now is the roe deer feed time. And since he's a max level and a diamond potential, I would love to drop him using the crossbow. So I'ma go there to pick up his track and I'ma try to surprise him while he's feeding. I hear something. Yeah, he's there. And he just ran away, just heard him. Damn. Oh, there he is. He stopped to feed right there. and he's in a great position to sneak up to it and use the crossbow once we're inside the ideal range. Luckily, the wind is in our favor, so there shouldn't be any issue. We are roughly 60 meters out. 56. Now almost at 40. So let's go for it. He won't go anywhere. Now let's see if it is a diamond. Well, he didn't die on the best position to take a picture, so we're just gonna harvest him and hopefully he'll be big enough. 83.08, he's a diamond. Finally a diamond roe deer on Hirschfelden after more than a year. And well, with that we conclude with this hunt. We still haven't been able to find any of the rares we need, but I'm sure that eventually one of these days we'll get lucky enough.